If we have not tried to ponder over the verses of the Quran, then we don't even understand why it was revealed. So every one of us needs to try our best to ponder over the verses of the Quran, and inshallah, this is what we will be trying to do during the month of Ramadan. I encourage myself and yourselves to try our best to read a portion of the Quran in a language that we understand as well. Because without that, we won't be able to succeed. Imagine Allah sends with us a manual to say, this is how you should operate yourself, and we don't know about that manual. I decided to spend a few moments to explain the importance of this book, because it is the month of the Quran. And not only the recitation in the Arabic language. Yes, that is important. Very important. But more than that is to understand the Quran, the message of Allah. I've heard people saying it is haram to read the meaning of the Quran. Where did they get that from? We want to know. How can we behave like those of the previous scriptures and prohibit our people from trying to understand the word of the one who made them? When Allah asks me, after I've died, and you, that I sent a book, did you read it? Did you try to understand it? What will our answer be? And then if he were to ask us, how many books have you read and understood? And we will be mentioning all the novels and all the little storybooks and fairy tales and bedtime stories that we've read. We give preference to Harry Potter over the Quran. It's a fact. We give preference to all these other books over the Quran. It's a fact. I think it's about time we use this Ramadan to change that. We can change it, and this is why we have reminders of this nature. This is why we are standing up here reminding ourselves and yourselves to say, it is about time, Ya Ummat al-Quran, O Ummah, O nation, whom the Quran has been sent to try and understand this book. I guarantee you it will change your life. I guarantee you it will raise you in spirituality without a bat of eyelid. Allahu Akbar. That is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, there are rules and regulations governing how to deal with a question that crops up on in your mind whilst you are reading the meaning. Those questions need to be answered by the professionals, the ulama, those who know. So when you come across a verse, you will find if there is a question in your mind, it would be wrong for you to answer it on your own. Go and ask the ulama. I read this verse, I don't understand it. But there are so many verses in the Quran that are very easily understood. The stories of the prophets, which makes the bulk of the Quran. That's why we want to go into it this year. Very easily understood. Allah tells us about Nuh, Noah. Allah tells us about Jacob, about Joseph, may peace be upon them all. Allah tells us about Lut, Lot, may peace be upon him. So it's important, inshallah, for us to make an effort to try and read these stories, to try and see why Allah revealed them, why Allah sent them down, for what reason. And then inshallah we see how everything is connected. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent messengers to mankind, He selected the best. He did not send messengers from amongst the worst or the mediocre of community. No. A Rasul or a Nabi was always selected the best of them. And this is why there are certain qualities that all the prophets had. We need to know these qualities. Because if we'd like to continue the work of the messengers, we need to try and learn from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected and chose. May He choose us all to serve His cause. Allah says, regarding some of His prophets, إِنَّهُ كَانَ مُخْلَصًا. Definitely He was chosen. Then Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى آدَمَ وَنُوحًا وَآلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَآلَ عِمْرَانَ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah has chosen Inna Allah astafa. Istafa means to choose. Inna Allah astafa Adam. Allah chose Adam. Alayhi salatu wassalam. We believe that whenever we say the name of a messenger, it is our duty to say, may peace be upon them. They have done a splendid job. In fact, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam says that there is a curse upon the one who says Muhammad without saying sallallahu alayhi wasallam. May peace be upon him. So some of these qualities, the messengers were always truthful. They never uttered a lie, even prior to prophethood. Never uttered a lie, even prior to prophethood. They were known by their people as truthful, always. One might ask, what about Ibrahim alayhi salam? We'll get to that inshallah. It's not actually a lie. It was something, and inshallah when we speak about Ibrahim alayhi salam in a few days time, we will get there. They were trustworthy and they were known as trustworthy, all of them. So in order for us to be chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to try our best to also be truthful and trustworthy. Because if a person is not truthful and utters lies, there is a chance they become champions of the devil and shaitan. Shaitan becomes pleased with them. We don't want that. So it's about time we started telling the truth. And it's about time we were honest and trustworthy. Then all the messengers were trained in a specific way. Do you know what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says? مَا مِن نَبِيٍّ إِلَّا وَرَعَ الْغَنَمِ. There was no Nabi except that he was a shepherd at one stage. He looked after some sheep. So Allah trained them. Allah trained them with sheep, with animals, before they came to human beings. Because what is more difficult? To look after animals or to look after human beings? I see the smiles, mashallah. Does someone have a doubt here? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our understanding. It is definitely more difficult to look after animals. But in the Quran, Allah describes certain people. He says, أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ. There are certain people who are like cattle, and in fact worse than cattle. Because with the sophisticated minds and brains and eyes and ears and noses that Allah has given mankind, they still don't want to hear, they don't want to see, they don't want to understand. Allah says, for those type of people, can we equate them to cattle? No, they are worse than cattle. Allahu Akbar. May Allah not make us from amongst those. So it's important for us all to have the quality in us to want to propagate what we have. We want to dish out what we have. That is a quality. The messengers had that quality. They wanted to give the message. They wanted to always spread the goodness. They were not selfish with it. So every time we learn something, let us try and think of ways of how to spread it. To whom? Let me tell you to whom. وَأَنذِرْ عَشِيرَتَكَ الْأَقْرَبِينَ. There was a stage when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was instructed to start primarily with his family members. So we start with those around us. We try and remind them. We want to tell them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us. Then there is another quality of the messengers. They were very intelligent. Allah did not send, astaghfirullah, people who were thick to a nation. No. Allah sent highly intelligent people. Look at Ibrahim alayhi salam. Allah says, subhanallah, that he had given Ibrahim al-hukma wal-nubuwata. Allah gave him so much. Allah gave him prophethood. Allah gave him wisdom. Allah gave him authority. When he was a young boy, look at how intelligent he was. He began questioning and he debated. Did you ever know that the messenger who has debated the most was Ibrahim alayhi salam? His debates are mentioned in the Quran. Allahu Akbar. He had the most debates. From a young age, he questioned. He asked the questions. And this is why for us, when the young ask questions, find answers for those questions. Sometimes they are innocent questions and we rattle out words of rebuke to these youngsters without even knowing that this might have shaped some negativity in the youngster's mind that will last forever because we did not answer the question. So it's important for us to try and look at the questions that are being asked, and we need to ask questions as well. There was a time when people used to say, don't ask. No, in Islam, it is simple to understand. We ask, But we have iman that when we are given an answer from Allah's revelation, we surrender to it. There we are. So there are certain things we may never understand, but we will try our best to. And there are certain explanations, for as long as those explanations are coming from revelation, inshallah we surrender to them. It's important for us to know this. So the Anbiya were always highly intelligent. Another quality of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, physically, they did not have any defect that was repulsive. Repulsive meaning chase people away. Rather, when you looked at them, you felt like getting closer. Allahu Akbar. All the messengers were described as very handsome. All of them. And they were not only good looking, but they had this like magnetism. Do you know what Abdullah ibn Salam radiallahu anhu says about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He says, Wallahi, when I saw the face of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I knew that this is not the face of a liar. The other Sahaba radiallahu anhum describe him and say, كَأَنَّهُ قِطْعَةُ قَمَرْ Allahu Akbar. As though he's a piece of the moon. Subhanallah. And they have all said, we have never seen anything more beautiful, more handsome than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So those who did not see the light and who did not come closer to him, they had to be really, really rejected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that to happen. It is reported that it is enough for a person to look at Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or to be in his company in order to be totally rectified and known as a sahabi and deserve after his name the word radiyallahu anhu. May Allah be pleased with him. Just by being with him for a moment as a mu'min, as a believer. But there were others who were fortunate and unfortunate. Who were they? They were the likes of Abu Jahl and the enemies of Islam who fought Islam and they fought Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were fortunate in that they lived in his midst, but they did not look at him with the eye of sincerity even once. Not even once. So for that reason, they did not receive that cleanliness. They did not receive that spiritual level of sahabi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again has chosen the sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then there is another very important point that we need to know. The messengers were all protected by Allah from committing sin. All of them were ma'sumeen. Ma'sumeen meaning they were protected by Allah from committing sin. Now one might ask, what about this deed that was done by Musa alayhi salam? Inshallah we will get to that. What about that which was done by this Nabi or that Nabi? We will get to that inshallah. They were protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from sin, and we need to know that and we believe that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala thereafter has kept certain merits in these messengers. The messengers, whenever they spoke, whenever they uttered, whatever they said, was inspired by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through divine revelation. And we know this about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah says in Surah Al-Najm, وَمَا يَنطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. He does not utter anything from himself. It is indeed revelation that was revealed. It was revelation that was revealed. So one might say, well look, once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked away from Abdullah ibn Maktum radiallahu anhu, and the Quran came and admonished him. So people say, well, what was that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had a lesson for us in that. Because sometimes it is the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let something happen so that when the solution of it is shown, or when the remedy of it is shown, the lesson can remain up to the end. We learn a lesson from that, that no matter how high you are, no matter how knowledgeable you are, no matter how much you think you know, when you are corrected, take it properly and accept it.